Everything that you've learned to do is entirely natural. How many people do this when they're trying to think of something? Or this? How many people, when they're stressed out or anxious, go like this? Or they get a headache and they go like this? These are natural movements. When you're embarrassed, where do you go? The throat chakra, every single time. Even guys do it, they just do it more surreptitiously than most women. Yeah? Everything that you've learned today, you do naturally anyway. You can do this in public, no problem. Absolutely no problem. You can do it at school and nobody will know. But it gives you the advantage, because when they're screaming their heads off and they're all upset about something, you can deal with it, because it's only the emotions that make things bad. Lots of people ask me, what can chinosis be used for? Lots of physical things are the results of stress, are the results of emotions, are the results of the way we perceive the world. Lots. Not everything. You can't cure a broken leg with chinosis or any other sort of therapy. What you can do is feel that it's really going to heal properly and it's going to heal really well. And what you will notice is that the healing time is shortened, because your immune system and your healing system can then get on with the job of working instead of the job of dealing with all these emotions. So you can clear emotions out. There's things that it can do, and there's things that it can't do. We've had some, to use a fairly British colloquialism, we've had some gobsmacking, some really amazing results. And the first result we had was something just a little bit amazing. And the person that it happened to is actually sitting here. So I want Jane to tell you about that.
I met John 5 years ago in a pub in Devon. And he said, "Oh, I want to try. I'd like to try this system out. Have you got any issues?" I said, "Well, no, not really." He said, "Have you got any problems?" I said, "Well, I've got a hyperactive thyroid, and I take lots of drugs for it. And if it doesn't get sorted soon, I'm going to have to go and have radioactive iodine, which shrinks the thyroid, and then you're left with a side effect, which means that you have to take thyroxine for the rest of your life because it goes." Underactive.
They nuke it.
And oh, he said, "Oh, that's interesting." So he said, "Okay, well, have you got any other issues?" And I said, "Well, I don't know, not really." And he said, "Okay, well, what do you want to deal with?" And I said, "Well, let's deal with fear." I don't know why I said that, but that's what we dealt with. And he said, "Okay, get a symbol for fear." And got a big green blob of slime, which was my symbol. And it took 10 minutes and I lost it. I lost the feeling for fear. It was really strange. You were doing your suds from 10 to naught. And when I did it, I just did one simple one. And he said, So where are your points now?" And it was very, very puzzling, because something had been there and then it wasn't there. It had gone. And basically, to cut a long story short, I stopped taking the tablets and I've never taken any since, and that's 5 years. And a few months after that, I went and had a blood test and everything was back to normal. There was no problem at all.
No, she went and had a blood test. Don't think that you don't need doctors to diagnose what's wrong with you. You do. They've got equipment and skills and capabilities that we, as lay people, do not have. Make use of them. It's stupid if you don't.
But it also had another strange side effect, and that was that for years and years and years I've had a sociophobia, which means that I've had a lot of problems eating and drinking in public, and I just thought it was me, so I sort of kept it and built up lots of strategies and didn't do a lot of things. I put a lot of things off, and probably for most of my life I wanted to be normal. I wanted to be able to go out and not spend hours and hours thinking about it and getting into a panic and all of that. And I just wanted to be able to be normal and go out and enjoy myself like everybody else seemed to be able to, and I couldn't. And there were so many things that I didn't do because I couldn't face being in that, getting myself into that situation. And I've never had it since. It was gone completely and absolutely. I've never, honest to God, I have never had a problem since. I'm a very pragmatic person. I'm very skeptical. It took me a good year to 2 years to really come to terms with it, because I was trying to find out why this had happened. I was thinking about it and trying to work out why. But in the end, I don't know why, but it happened. And so I'm now a huge believer in energy and in the power of the mind over whatever it is that controls us, that we can take control. I mean, it's completely changed my life, because I'm doing this now, and I wouldn't have been doing it. There's no way you would have got me into this situation. No way I would have sat and talked to people like this. No way I would have sat down and ate and had anything to drink with people in
certainly
this situation.
Certainly wouldn't be sitting in front of a camera, would you?
No way would I've been. I mean, for 5 years now, we've been training people, and we go to hotels. We have breakfast with people. I mean, breakfast with people. Good grief. And I do that now without any problems at all. No problems at all. It has absolutely changed my life.
You can change your life. That's fairly gobsmacking. If you take nothing else from today, take the fact that you can change your life. You don't have to settle for ones. You can do zeros. You don't have to settle for eights. You can do tens. It's freedom. It's freedom in the most vital way, because it's your choice.
Mm.